Imagine stepping into virtual worlds that are indistinguishable from ours, or owning a robot that learns complex tasks as effortlessly as you can watch a video. In the latest AI developments, Nvidia's groundbreaking AI graphics reconstruction models are redefining what's possible in video games, while the newest machine intelligence let robots watch and learn from humans to completely take over tasks. So stick around, and let's delve into how these innovations set the stage for a future that's straight out of a science fiction movie, with Nvidia just announcing DLSS 3.5 as the newest release of their deep learning supersampling technology. Specifically designed to enhance ray tracing performance and quality in video games and Nvidia Omniverse. Plus, their new AI model, aptly named Ray Reconstruction, is the champion of these enhancements. It significantly improves ray tracing by superseding traditional manually tuned denoisers. To create realistic lighting effects, ray tracing calculates the interaction of light rays with various materials. However, individually tracing every pixel becomes incredibly demanding, leading games to use ray sampling, which unfortunately results in less clarity or noisy images. It falls on denoisers to fill in the missing visual data, but this process isn't flawless and often introduces disruptive artifacts. Nvidia's DLSS 3.5 alleviates this problem by utilizing a supercomputer-endowed neural network to analytically study ray-traced effects, which then make discerning decisions on how to utilize temporal and spatial data to preserve detail. The uniqueness of their Ray Reconstruction AI model lies in its ability to recognize patterns from offline rendered training data, which it uses to reconstruct effects such as real-time global illumination. This ingenious approach surpasses the limitations of standard denoisers by completely eliminating artifacts like inaccurate lighting and reflections that adversely impact image quality. For games that heavily rely on ray tracing, DLSS 3.5 enhances performance by replacing several denoisers with a solitary ray reconstruction model. However, for games less exposed to ray tracing, DLSS 3.5 has been designed to prioritize image quality over performance. The final result? Superior lighting, reflections, and detail, giving users an unprecedented gaming experience. Nvidia has proudly announced that over 330 games are already using DLSS technology, which is continuously evolving through their persistent research in the realm of artificial intelligence, and the company has plans to further capitalize on the progress of DLSS as they refine the graphics and rendering industries. Furthermore, Nvidia also mentioned that its AI-ready servers support VMware Private AI Foundation to help businesses power their generative AI solutions. These AI-ready servers would include Nvidia L40S GPUs, BlueField 3 DPUs, and Nvidia AI Enterprise software, with these integrations being aimed to enable enterprises to meticulously fine-tune their generative AI foundation models and deploy various applications like intelligent chatbots, search and summarization tools. In terms of processing prowess, the L40S GPUs are architectural marvels. Designed to handle complex AI workloads with billions of parameters, they deliver over 1.45 petaflops of tensor processing power and up to 1.7 times the training performance compared to the A100 Tensor Core GPU. Businesses can anticipate AI-ready servers featuring L40S GPUs and BlueField DPUs by the end of this year, with instances from cloud service providers expected in the ensuing months. It's safe to say that Nvidia's transformative technological advancements will continue to refine and redefine our gaming and business experiences. But that's not all, because the robotics world is also buzzing with excitement as the most recent eye-in-hand cameras have opened exciting new frontiers in vision-based robotic manipulation. However, an obstacle that was proving to be a big-ticket road bump was the expensive collection of expert demonstrations required for robotic imitation. But now, a new line of approach is poised to revolutionize this paradigm shift for robotic imitation datasets with human video demonstrations. This innovative solution surfaces from the simple fact that videos of humans performing tasks are significantly cheaper to collect, eliminating the need for expertise in robotic teleoperation. The potential of this data collection method was overwhelmingly untapped until recently, when researchers leveraged it to exponentially boost the generalization prowess of eye-in-hand visuomotor policies. In a series of tests involving a range of real-world tasks, from basic 3 degrees of freedom operations to a complex 6 degrees of freedom robot arm control, the trial witnessed an impressive absolute success rate improvement of about 58%. The key takeaway: robots can now adeptly adapt to different environment configurations and new tasks unseen in the robot demo data. Surely the cost and prowess of such a robotic mechanism raise questions. Do we really need to rely on these high-end, expensive data collection methods? Especially when the primary goal of robots is to mimic humans, the solution seems glaringly simple. Use human demonstration videos. This technique provides a cost-effective alternative. It eliminates the need for constant robot resets, hardware debugging, and time-consuming repositioning. Of course, integrating human demonstrations into robotic realms isn't quite the cakewalk it seems. The issue arises due to the distinct dissimilarity in appearances between humans and robots, leading to a significant distribution shift. Enter the new research called Giving Robots a Hand, which is bridging this human-robot divide. Earlier methods, primarily employing third-person camera viewpoints, navigated this challenge using domain adaptation strategies. These included image translations, domain invariant visual representations, and even key point information usage about human and robot states. In a refreshing contrast, Giving Robots a Hand introduces a straightforward solution, masking a consistent portion of each image, thus making the human hand or robotic end effector invisible. Bypassing the need for complex domain adaptation techniques, this strategy enables robots to learn manipulation policies directly from human videos. It successfully rectifies issues like visual inconsistencies resulting from human-to-robot image translations, prevalent in earlier domain adaptation methods. The secret weapon of Giving Robots a Hand lies in its exploration methodology that weaves in wide-ranging eye-in-hand human video demonstrations, thereby enhancing both environment and task generalization. The outcomes are truly commendable. A broad range of real-world robotic manipulation tasks witnessed significant performance enhancements, from basic reaching and grasping operations to complex tasks such as pick and place, cube stacking, plate clearing, and toy packing. The method's key highlight, a drastic improvement in generalization, enables policies to adapt to unfamiliar environments and novel tasks unseen during robot demonstrations. The upshot? A staggering average surge of 58% in absolute success rates in unknown environments and tasks, which the approaches solely reliant on robot demonstrations failed to achieve. This exceptional advancement indeed signifies a giant leap for robotic manipulations and promises a rosy outlook into the future. As we stand on the precipice of a new era, where artificial intelligence not only promises to enhance our gaming escapades, but also rewrites the rulebook for robotics, it's clear that we're witnessing the dawn of a technological renaissance. The synergy between these advancements hints at a world where our digital and physical realities are seamlessly integrated, enriched, and simplified. From pixel-perfect reflections in virtual lakes to robots that can learn from human behavior, the line between what's possible and impossible is continuing to blur.